They're staples of many a primetime police procedural. Crime scene investigators. They're scientists helping to solve all sorts of crimes. Perhaps none more unusual than those our Conor Knighton has been looking into.
At this crime lab in Oregon, an elite team of super sleuths examines evidence sent in from across the world. Their tools may look familiar, but their cases can get pretty wild. Welcome to CSI Ashland, home of the National Fish and Wildlife Forensics Laboratory.
We're the only U.S. federal crime lab devoted to criminal investigations focusing on wildlife.
Barry Baker is the deputy director of the lab, founded in 1988 to solve wildlife crimes.
When we're talking wildlife crime, I assume that means human versus wildlife crime. This is not wildlife on wildlife crime. This is
correct.
If an eagle steals something from a fox den, we're not investigating that.
Yeah, we're looking for evidence of humans committing crimes against animals.
There are many different breeds of crime. The lab is run by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service and supports the investigations of more than 200 special agents and inspectors in the U.S., and works with more than 150 countries, which have signed the UN's Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora Treaty. Quite a bit of the lab's work involves illegal products made from animals. Everything from fur coats, to purses, to ivory sculptures crafted out of elephant tusks. When an agent at a port or shipping facility sees something suspicious, that gets sent in.
There was a large shipment in Miami that was seized a few years ago where they were attempting to smuggle these and claiming that it was blue plastics for recycling, where in fact they were painting them to try to disguise the fact that they came from sea turtles and they were being smuggled.
I mean, I can certainly see why someone might fall for this.
Using forensic science, the lab can not only figure out what something is, but potentially where that protected species came from, which can be helpful when tracking down poachers. Officers out in the field work the cases, but they need their evidence to be analyzed here.
Why have so many different varieties of antelope? Why is this helpful to you?
Yeah, so there are so many animals that are in the wildlife trade that we need representatives to help us identify them when they come to us as evidence.
The lab maintains a giant repository of specimens, both seized and donated, to use as references when they need to make comparisons during active investigations. They've got everything from bugs to bison. There are drawers of bones and birds.
This is my to-do list.
Johnny French is the human in charge of the collection.
In here is all of our donated specimens from zoos. So this big pile right here is a giraffe. Back in the back, there's an orangutan. There's a gorilla in here, a couple of bonobos.
Does anybody accidentally leave their lunch in here?
Oh, absolutely not.
There is lunch in here, though, for the flesh-eating beetles who clean the bones before specimens can be examined or added to the library. There's never a dull moment in the world of wildlife forensics.
I always get to learn something every day. You know the old saying, if you're the smartest person in the room, you're in the wrong room? I've never been in the wrong room here. So if you have a question, you always have a world-renowned expert that you can just go and ask.
In the exam room, you'll find veterinary forensic pathologist Rebecca Kagan.
Basically, I solve mysteries. There's a dead animal, and they want to know how it died, and I figure out what happens.
The lab doesn't accept live animals, but when wildlife dies under suspicious circumstances, Kagan is on the case.
Red-tailed hawks are significantly larger.
Sometimes teaming up with coworkers like ornithologist Jessica Terrell.
There's the feet.
Wow.
An animal might have been electrocuted. If it turns out that's because a power company didn't take proper precautions, that could end up being a crime. It might have been poisoned. Maybe it was shot.
A lot of these condors are lead poisoning cases.
That's or maybe really... it was not.
The ingested metal is right here.
This bird literally ate lead. It ingested a bullet used to kill a different animal. When animals are the victims, clues can be hard to come by.
Unlike a human mysterious death where the neighbor can say, yeah, I saw them yesterday, or, you know, they didn't collect their mail, and those are clues that help you figure out when somebody died. We don't get any of that with wildlife.
The team here also gets very little information about how their findings are ultimately used, and that's by design. They're not told much about the cases so that they're not biased.
Federal authorities made some key discoveries, bones of big cats.
Of course, some cases are so big, they find out anyway.
This is what the Tiger King was doing to his tigers. He was putting bullets in the brain case of his old tigers.
French realized after the fact that he'd worked on tigers which looked similar to this specimen. Used in the trial, which led to the conviction of the man known as Joe Exotic.
Counts 3 through 7 of the indictment are for shooting and killing 5 tigers.
Made famous in the Netflix documentary series, Tiger King. Doing this type of work can take a toll.
Do you find yourself thinking about the life that that animal lived?
I try not to. It's better not to. This is a hard enough job. It's a rewarding job, but it's hard enough without thinking of what people are willing to do for animals.
There are certainly people who are willing to do almost anything to obtain a rare or endangered animal. The illegal trade in wildlife is estimated to be worth $20 billion a year. But the existence of a lab like this is also evidence of the good people are willing to do for animals, solving cases on behalf of creatures who can't speak for themselves.
This isn't just a United States problem, it's not just a country of origin problem for where these animals live. This is a problem that humanity really needs to think about and focus on how we're going to proceed living with this planet.